and amend it. Okay. Resolutions, petitions. Okay, we're going to get to the next steps. So Montgomery County, Pennsylvania, also tried to do a second Bill of Rights. They're in the process of suing their commissioners. The point is here that people rule, not property. People rule.
Yeah.
Okay. So what happened in my kind of gallop around the country was that I found all these places doing this, but nobody knew about anybody else. So that was part of the coalition, is to build this coalition. Now, what would change if we actually passed these amendments? Well, we could, under First Amendment, we could prohibit all political activity. We could boot these guys out of our campaigns, out of the pockets of our politicians, and out of Congress with lobbying. This is a First Amendment right they have now. Nonsense. This is where you're going to get the compromises in Congress. This is why we cannot solve the climate crisis until we solve the democracy crisis. It's because this First Amendment crap that allows for compromises. So we can stop false ads, we can require truth in labeling, and this is Fourth Amendment, where the corporations can demand a search warrant from our federal agencies who come in to do inspections for worker safety problems, food safety problems, product safety, pollution of air and water. Sixth and seventh are about having a right to a jury trial. This is why we, the people, are even ending up in court against these ridiculous size corporations instead of just suing, just saying, here's the fine, pay it. And believe it or not, what the constitutional scholars are saying now is that they're going for the second. That's going to be the next one. The second is the right to bear arms. McDonald's with arms, okay? Bad trouble. I don't think Ronald McDonald would look too good with an AK-47. So what can I do? This is how we're growing this movement in America. We're asking people, now I got another whole list for you guys, okay? But in America, we're asking people to go back to the basics. Go back to where you grow democracy, in the grassroots. Go back to your kitchen table, invite people over, serve up food for the stomach, food for the soul. On this website, ultimatecivics.org, is a whole bunch of study guides and material and talks, and so that you can start this basic education process and then going about passing an ordinance or resolution. This is also a good idea for student governance across America to consider. Okay? Blanket across America. Resolution saying, you know, no on corporate personhood. And we will have templates up, I hope, soon. There's a huge Facebook discussion going on with over 4,000 people on it. And we can share information. What works in Pennsylvania? What worked in California? What didn't work? You know, there's learning. When we're trying to build a movement here. And remember, the abolitionists started on campuses, right? Okay, so why do we need to do this? Because, again, our leaders have warned what will happen if we don't. Franklin Delano Roosevelt said, the liberty of a democracy is not safe if the people tolerate the growth of private power to the point where it becomes greater than their democratic state itself. That, in essence, is fascism. So if we're going to separate corporation and state, we're going to separate democracy and capitalism, which we have to do, but we shouldn't be calling it democracy. We need to do this not necessarily for us, but for the even younger ones that are coming up. I mean, if we're going to pass a living planet on, this is the way we have to do it. And I want to end with one more story, what we did in Cordova, because this is a time for serious action, okay? And what happened in Cordova after the fish runs collapsed in 1992 and 93, our economy completely collapsed. And people were desperate. We didn't know, it was the young fish that were spawned in the oil spill that didn't survive as the adults were putting. So there was like this delayed collapse 4 years after the oil spill, okay? And what we did was, Exxon was roaring around saying everything's fine. You know, Exxon, climate change, everything's fine, right? No worries. And we were desperate. So when you have nothing to lose, it's actually a very freeing moment, because then you're not afraid. You're not afraid of consequences. And this is where the entire community came to. We had nothing left to lose. So we took our fishing boats and we blockaded Valdez Narrows, which is a geologic bottleneck, and we held oil tanker traffic for was 25% of the nation's oil at the time. This is August of 1993. This was a big deal. The Department of Energy sent in the FBI, but we had, they got as far as Valdez. We had all the boats, right? Dictates the energy future. And to do that, we've got to change the rules.